Come and go with me to our Father's house, to our Father's house, to our Father's house. Come and go with me to our Father's house, where there's joy, joy, joy. Jesus is the way to our Father's house, to our Father's house, to our Father's house. Jesus is the way to our Father's house, where there's
Mass is offered for the following intentions: the worthy blessings for Sharon Pereira, Johan Rajaram, Kyra Hansu, Ashwin D'Souza, Samuel Suarez, Osman Norona, Lucas Uzagine. Thanksgiving for good health and blessings received by the De Lima, Fernandez and D'Souza families. Worthy remembrance for Jane Gonzalez, for the souls of Arthur Dunbar, Mansmine, Elizabeth Sconey Rodericks, Phyllis Mascarenhas, Celine Godard, Valentino Mascarenhas, Darren Ratnaike, Alan Nunes, Carmen Coutinho, the deceased members of the Pereira, Menezes, D'Souza, and Mesquita families. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit,
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
From the desert of the first Sunday of Lent to the mountain of the second Sunday, our Lord takes us today to the temple. As we gather around the Eucharistic table with praise and thanksgiving in our hearts, let us also seek pardon and forgiveness for all our sins. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault, therefore I ask the Blessed Mary ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, author of every mercy and of all goodness, who in fasting, prayer and almsgiving have shown us a remedy for sin, look graciously on this confession of our loneliness, that we who are bowed down by our conscience may always be lifted up by your mercy. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Exodus. In those days, God spoke all these words, saying, I am the Lord your God, who brought you out of the land of Egypt, out of the house of slavery. You shall have no other gods before me. You shall not take the name of the Lord your God in vain. For the Lord will not hold him guiltless who takes his name in vain. Remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy. Honor your father and your mother, that your days may be long in the land that the Lord your God is giving you. You shall not murder. You shall not commit adultery. You shall not steal. You shall not bear false witness against your neighbor. You shall not covet your neighbor's house. You shall not covet your neighbor's wife, or his male servant, or his female servant, or his ox, or his donkey, or anything that is your neighbor's. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our response is, Lord, you have the words of eternal life. Kindly listen to the tune.
Lord, you have
revives the soul. The decrees of the Lord are steadfast. They give wisdom to the simple. All together.
Lord, you are the words of eternal life.
The precepts of the Lord are right. They gladden the heart. The command of the Lord is clear. It gives light to the eyes. All together.
Lord, you are the words of eternal life.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brethren, Jews demand signs and Greeks seek wisdom. But we preach Christ crucified, a stumbling block to Jews and folly to Gentiles. But to those who are called, both Jews and Greeks, Christ the power of God and the wisdom of God. For the foolishness of God is wiser than men, and the weakness of God is stronger than men. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Praise to you, O Christ, King of eternal glory.
God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish but have eternal life.
Praise to you, O Christ, King of eternal glory.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The Passover of the Jews was at hand, and Jesus went up to Jerusalem. In the temple, he found those who were selling oxen and sheep and pigeons, and the money changers sitting there, and making a whip of cords. He drove them all out of the temple with the sheep and oxen. And he poured out the coins of the money changers and overturned their tables. And he told those who sold the pigeons, "Take these things away. Do not make my Father's house a house of trade." His disciples remembered that it was written, "Zeal for your house will consume me." So the Jews said to him, "What sign do you show us for doing these things?" Jesus answered them, "Destroy this temple, and in 3 days I will raise it up." The Jews then said, "It has taken 46 years to build this temple, and will you raise it up in 3 days? But he was speaking about the temple of his body. When therefore he was raised from the dead, his disciples remembered that he had said this, and they believed the scripture and the word that Jesus had spoken. Now when he was in Jerusalem at the Passover feast, many believed in his name when they saw the signs that he was doing. But Jesus, on his part, did not entrust himself to them, because he knew all people and needed no one to bear witness about man, for he himself knew what was in man." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Brothers and sisters, there are different ways in which people express their anger. And we know that anger is a problem with many people, many of us. There was a husband who once asked his wife, "Darling, how do you manage to keep your cool when I get upset with you and I scream and shout? You never seem to fight back. How do you control your anger?" And the wife replied, "I just go and clean the toilet." The husband was surprised and asked, "How does that help?" The wife replied, "I use your toothbrush." It is Aristotle who said, "It is easy to become angry. Anyone can do it. But to become angry at the right moment, to the right degree, for the right purpose, in the right manner, that is difficult. And only the wise person can accomplish it." What is implied in Aristotle's words is the realization that there are different types of anger. There is destructive anger, which is unfocused, irrational, and wasteful. But there is also something called a constructive anger that is precise, appropriate, and useful. Aristotle believed that constructive anger is valuable. So did our Lord Jesus Christ. In today's gospel, we see Jesus using constructive anger in this dramatic action in the temple. We are not completely sure as to why Jesus was angry, what was he angry at. He was not angry at the temple itself, for he was a good Jew. And for him, the temple was the center of his religious life, and he prayed in the temple often. He could not be angry at the fact that people were selling animals, because animals were required by the Jewish law for sacrifice. Perhaps he was angry at where the animals were being sold or how they were being sold. Perhaps they were being sold in an unfair manner that was discriminating against the poor. Whatever the reason is, it is clear that Jesus perceived some injustice in this action of selling, and his response to this injustice was anger. Anger motivated Jesus to act against what he believed was wrong. The example of Jesus reminds us that as children of God, we are required to do much more than just sitting in prayer and promoting a peaceful inner disposition. We are required to act on behalf of what is right, to oppose every evil, oppression, and discrimination. We do these things because we believe that they are contrary to God's kingdom. In this action against evil, there is a kind of anger that is useful. Constructive anger is a virtue when it is exercised on behalf of the kingdom. Now, this can surprise us because many of us have been taught that anger is a sin. But only destructive anger is sinful. Constructive anger is not a sin. It is a positive and valuable part of human life. Reflect on your own life in the past year. If you cannot think of any time when you were angry, that is necessarily not a good thing. Never being angry does not make us extra holy. In fact, it might indicate that we are indifferent to injustice and the evils that are part of our world. If, on the other hand, you look over the past year and realize that you always have been angry, then that is not a good thing either. When we suddenly burst into a rage at the slightest comment, when we explode without any reason, when we discover that we are constantly living with an internal tension, there is an indication that there are certain unresolved issues in our life that need to be dealt with. And that is where destructive anger creeps in. And this destructive anger needs to be channelized well. But contrary to never being angry or always being angry, constructive anger is healthy. It helps us identify what is wrong and it motivates us to work against it. If you realize in your life a growing tendency towards self-indulgence and self-centeredness, constructive anger can help motivate you to act, to turn things around. If you realize that you are experiencing a certain abuse in your relationships, whether in the home or whether in your place of work or in society, constructive anger can force you to demand a change or to abandon the relationship altogether. Our Lord Jesus did something in the temple, and the people who were observing him possibly found that he was foolish. Listen to the words of today's second reading. It tells us about the foolishness of God. And this foolishness of God was evident in the offer of his only son to suffer and die on the cross. The act of God or of Jesus on the cross appeared foolish as a scandal. But then we know that the apostles who began to preach a crucified Christ began to get so many people to believe in this Christ that this foolishness was turned to wisdom. Brothers and sisters, we must always remember this, that God is merciful, that God is love. That does not mean that Jesus could not be angry. This happens in our own lives as well. We tend to get angry at God at times. We may try to suppress that anger. But we must bring this anger to our Lord in prayer. Whoever has said that we cannot get angry with our loved ones in the family, especially when we want to show them constructive anger, in the same manner, it is good to be angry, to express ourselves, and to get a clarity of thought. Let us believe then that the Lord of peace is also a Lord of justice. And just as he upturned the money changers' tables, in the same way, we must be able during the season to overturn so many things around us that are affecting our relationship with God and with each other. Amen. We profess our faith together. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. We pray in surrender to a God who is loving and merciful. Our response is, hear our prayer, O Lord. Together. Hear our prayer.
May bring healing to the people as he carries the Lord's eternal message of love and mercy. We pray to the Lord.
Hear our prayer, O Lord.
For all our political leaders, that all their projects and plans may bring benefit to all, irrespective of caste, gender, and religious orientation. We pray to the Lord.
Hear our prayer, O Lord.
For all of us celebrating the season of Lent, that we may cleanse and strengthen the temples of our beings as we pray and renew our relationship with God and each other. We pray to the Lord.
Hear our prayer, O Lord.
For our children and youth, that in the midst of all the insecurity rampant in the world, they may never lose focus on God's blessings and mercy. We pray to the Lord.
Hear our prayer, O Lord.
For our personal needs and intentions, that we may enjoy the blessings of a merciful God who listens to the prayers we make in silence. We pray to the Lord.
Hear our prayer, O Lord.
Abba Father, we are grateful to you for your merciful love and for listening to our prayers which we make through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Take our bread, we ask you, take our hearts, we love you, take our lives, for Father, we are yours, we are yours. Yours as we stand at the table you shed, yours as we eat the bread our hearts can forget. We are the signs of your life with us yet. We are yours. We are yours. Take our bread. We ask you, take our hearts. We love you, take our lives. Oh, Father, we are yours. We are yours.
Let us pray that your sacrifice and mine may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands and praise and glory of his name for our good and for our
Holy Spirit. Be pleased, O Lord, with these sacrificial offerings, and grant that we who beseech pardon for our sins may take care to forgive our neighbor through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you have given your children a sacred time for the renewing and purifying of their hearts, that freed from disordered affections, they may so deal with the things of this passing world as to hold rather to the things that eternally endure. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna.
Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
We pray.
We offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Oswald our Bishop and all the clergy.
Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And graciously grant a peace and unity in accordance with your will, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
We offer each other a sign of peace. Peace be with you. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Our act of spiritual communion together. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
This is my commandment, love one another as I have loved you. Charity is kind, feels no envy, love one another as I have loved you. This is my commandment, love one another as I have loved you.
Let us pray. Merciful Father, we thank you and praise you for the gift of your Son Jesus to us. We surrender into your hands our fears and our insecurities, our worries, our tensions, and even our anger. We know, Lord, that there are times when we cannot deal with it. We pray that you may bring healing in our hearts, and to help us use it constructively. Forgive us for the times we have been destructive in the use of our anger, through words and actions that have destroyed the peace and even destroyed our relationships. Lord, as we surrender ourselves into your hands, we pray that you may give us the strength to be effective citizens and your disciples in the world. Bless every effort of ours to bring healing and relation in our relationships. We pray that we may always reflect your mercy and your love in the relationships we share. Bless us and protect us and keep us safe. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Announcement about Masses. Masses for April 2021 may be offered online via the email ID of the parish, which is parishofficemcc@yahoo.com, or dropped in the box marked Mass Intentions outside the parish office from Monday, March 8, 2021. Please write only two intentions per family with a proper date the Mass is to be offered for the month of April. Your address and contact number, your optional monetary offering for the Mass, and seal it in an envelope with the word Mass Intentions written on the envelope. We will not be entertaining any intentions on separate pieces of paper anymore because of accounting procedures. Those offering Masses online have to follow the same instructions, only two intentions with a proper date, and transfer of optional monetary intentions for the Mass via NEFT procedure, the details of which will be provided to you by request. The last date for offering Masses for the month of April is Friday, March 26th. Please note that there will be no intentions announced on the 1st, 2nd and 3rd of April because these fall within the sacred Triduum. The Lord be with you. May the blessings of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit descend upon you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
We go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
God of grace and